I imagine you're getting used to this by now. Wonderful. Let's keep it up. I'll cut down everything in my way.
Continuing mission.
Thank you.
You should leave before I change my mind.
I have no time for this.
How annoying.
These stairs look terribly unsafe. It does seem like an effective way to keep intruders out, though. The cage is just filled with mysteries, isn't it? Oh, that's... It's the monster that attacked us earlier. Are you going to chase it? It's almost like it's calling to us. It's not here. Well, let's take care of the scarecrow for now.
Soldiers' voices drift in from outside. The kingdom has once again declared war. The boy looks at the man and opens his heart. He once lacked the courage to stand against his father and had stayed complicit. But now he burns to stop the king and protect his people from the horrors of war. The passion in his eyes is evident. The man breaks through the door, and the boy follows after.
I shall take care of them.
Come. I've got enough death for everyone.
As a divine light shines behind him, the king glares down at the two interlopers. In a bold voice, the boy shouts up at the king. By my name as the firstborn, I propose this war be ended. In that moment, he is just like the hero of his song. With a sneer, the king looks to the clockwork soldier and says, the man freezes, but he cannot disobey his master, for that is how he was programmed. With a shaking hand, he readies his gun. The boy stares straight at the man from the end of the barrel. Unable to resist his orders, the man's finger hovers over the trigger. In a final, desperate move, the man shuts down his own motor circuits. His finger lets go of the trigger, and he falls to his knees before the boy. It is the first time he has resisted orders of his own volition, all to save the boy. With an animalistic cry, the king rises up before the pair.
I shall take care of them.
Too slow.
The king's roar brings soldiers running as he demands they tear the traitors apart. The man seizes the boy's hand, and they begin to run from the castle. For the first time in his existence, the man finally has a will of his own.
Driven from his country. The king wished for control, while the prince prayed for peace and happiness. They were both thinking of their country, so why did it have to end up so?
Thank you.